In this part, I'm going to detail the Azure Data Factory pipeline and which activity that we can integrate it in this pipeline.
In order to work with Azure Data Factory's pipeline, it's imperative to understand what is a pipeline. A pipeline, it represents a logical grouping of activity where the activity together perform a certain task. An example for a combination of activity is one pipeline can be ingesting and cleaning logged data in combination with the mapping data flow that analyzes the log data that has been cleaned. A pipeline enables you to manage the separate individual activity as a set which would you other side be managed individually. It enables you to deploy and schedule the activity efficiently through the use of a single pipeline versus managing each activity independently. Activities in a pipeline are referred to action that you perform on your data. Activity can take zero or more input dataset and produce one or more output dataset. An example for an action can be used of a copy activity where you copy your data from Azure SQL database to Azure SQL Data Lake Gen 2. To build on this example, you can use a data flow activity or an Azure Databricks notebooks for processing and transforming the data that was copied to your Azure Data Lake Gen 2 account. In order to have a data ready for business intelligence reporting solution like in Azure Synapse Analytics. Since there are many activities that are possible in a pipeline in Azure Data Factory, you have grouped activity in the is category. Data movement activity, the copy activity in Azure Data Factory copy the data from a source data store to a sync data store. Data transformation activity, Azure Data Factory support transform activity such as Azure Data Flow, Azure Function, Spark, and another that can be added to the pipeline, either the individual or chain it within other activity. A control activity, example for a control activity are gets metadata for each and execute a pipeline. Activity can depend on each other. What we mean is the activity depend defines how the subsequent activity depend on a previous activity. The dependency itself can be based on a condition of whatever the continuous of the execution of the previous defined activity in order to complete a task. An activity that depend on one or more previous activity can have different dependency conditions. For example, succeed, fail, skip, complete.